Hello everyone, I'm Davide. I'm the one Italian guy who writes books about Adobe extensibility. And why am I the only one? I don't know, more people should get involved. There is very little competition. It's good for the business. I'm obviously here to promote my books, but that's boring. So I thought it would be better for me to try to provide some value or at the very least some entertainment. So I decided to revamp a presentation I gave in 2023 that is called the UXP Landscape Guide, but let's scrap that too. We don't have enough time. So I'm gonna switch to something that I have titled How to Learn UXP, Solving the Dreadful Problem of Knowing What to Learn. And let's blur Sally here because, you know, IP infringement. And everything starts from someone proclaiming their interest in building a Photoshop plugin. That is cool, bold move. Now, what does that mean in terms of stuff you've got to learn, or at the very least, have a general awareness of? Well, the Adobe extensibility landscape is vast, but unlike Italian pasta, where every kind does make total sense, and I dare you to say the opposite, we can try to simplify things here. So there is scripting and stuff that makes use of scripting, and in doing so, it adds tremendous value and power. Leaving aside C++ extensibility for a moment on purpose, more on that later. Now, scripting, we all know, it's a way to programmatically drive an application with code. Sometimes limited, not every feature is exposed to the scripting layer. And we also live in this peculiar moment in time where we can use either ExtensiCrypt or modern JavaScript as UXP, but not both at the same time. You've got to like pick your poison. And let's jump straight into CEP. And believe me, when I showed this slide, I could like feel waves of hostility coming towards me because the CEP is fading out, but it's still going strong in some application. And fun fact, Chris and I are showing the same comic here. If you are in an enterprise environment where the entire pipeline holds up because of a CEP workflow of yours, then fine, but start porting to UXP. I trust you started like a couple of years ago. So let me explain why it was dead to me. And in case you don't know, the sweet lady, she's a fictional character who spreads death wherever she happens to show up. So I decided to quit the very moment Photoshop engineers decided not to bundle CEP into the native version of the application for the new Apple Silicon Macs, which meant that you had to tell your customers that if they wanted to keep using your indispensable extension, they had to use Photoshop in Intel compatibility mode, which was gross. And so I moved on. Okay, so it's still relevant. And what are the pros? Well, it's a standard environment, which has possibly spoiled us a bit. And it uses ExtensiCrypt, the good old scripting language we all know and love. And on the con side, it uses ExtensiCrypt, the worn out scripting language we all want to move on from. And V8 and passing scripting messages back and forth stinks. I mean, it works, but come on. And it also has a very heavy footprint, like anything with Chrome in the name. So here comes UXP, which has all sorts of upsides, and lighter and safer. It supports a single JavaScript engine. You can import C++ routines, and especially it has new features. People used to complain about stuff that didn't make it into the CEP to UXP transition, but what about brand new stuff? And more on that in a moment. And finally, in my opinion, the best insurance policy against obsolescence ever, it's used massively internally in several CC applications for the native features. So what can you build in UXP? Well, application features versus whatever contraption a browser can digest. And that's a different mindset. It's austere maybe, but effective. And then there will be someone saying it's not ready for prime time, in which case let me hijack my own presentation here and show you a UXP plugin named Mind the Color by my friend Carlo Diamanti. It makes use of basic UXP features to implement rather advanced tools and techniques look at this vector scope thing here, and this precious masking tool that uses a curve in the hue space, and there are also lab curves for RGB documents, as well as hue versus luminosity curves and loads of other stuff. You can find it here. I believe it's still for sale at the discounted price, and I don't get any money from it, just to be clear. All right, so stuff to learn. Since Adobe contains multitudes, there are always two. On the one side, the environment API, which is the UXP API now, which you use to build the UI, control the lifecycle, the event handling, and so on, and the host application, Photoshop API, the InDesign API, the scripting thing. And what can I do to ease your learning journey? Thanks for asking. I have two books. This one is about the UXP API, and it's dear to me because I've spent a huge amount of time threading together UXP and React JS. Learning stuff is an unhappy business. It is. And you should at least be spared the effort of figuring out what to learn and in which order. That's my job. And also, you get no extra baggage. React.js features show up exactly when you need them, and that's a happy coincidence, isn't it? And also, I discuss the plugin business because, you know, sustenance. And then there's the Photoshop API book, exciting new stuff about it. The DOM has been rebuilt from scratch. Action Manager is in a retirement facility, and we have the easier Action JSON. And let's talk about the imaging API, getting and setting pixels. Can you believe it? And hybrid C++ plugins that I cover for the ones who dare. And I've also stuffed some AI in it, which is Adobe Intelligence, I believe. Apologies, I couldn't help myself. Okay, let me skim through some pages quickly. On the imaging API, that means direct access to pixels as arrays, unheard of until very recently in Photoshop. You can do stuff like clipping warning, change a pixel color if it falls under a certain value, or extracting a channel in a different color space. On the right, there is the A channel from lab in an RGB image, which is then manipulated, again, all numeric stuff, to get a precise reds mask. You can do saturation masks rather easily. And what about steganography, hiding secret text messages within images, tweaking the least significant bits of pixels? How cool is that? And machine learning, that's the demo plugin, which performs object detection via TensorFlow, and it's locally, you don't need any internet connection. It's all self-contained. It's possible, and I show you how. And I have experimented with WebAssembly. You can use different languages. Here is Rust that's compiled to WASM to recreate an instant Perlin noise generator, which for some reason is something I've always been fascinated with. And I want to conclude with an experiment that I did. I stumbled upon this book, which is called Digital Image Processing with C++ by David Champerlé, who is a French researcher and the author of an open source image library called C-Image. So I got in touch with him, and he's been so kind to allow me to use a non-trivial image processing routine described in his book. You have to calculate something called the norm grab for each pixel and then subdivide the image into quadrant stuff. The problem is, I knew nothing about C++. Like, I didn't even know how to set up the IDE, let alone debug. So what's my experiment? I tried to use mid-2023 artificial intelligence, which is not the smartest one by today's standards, and see whether it would allow me to, well, on the one side, get stuff done, but more importantly, guide me through a learning process. I wanted to learn it. And lo and behold, after like 3 kilometers of chat log, I made it, showing that AI can be used to augment your knowledge, to improve. And in due course, I thoroughly documented the process. So now you know how to implement any image processing routines with hybrid C++ plugin yourselves too. Look at that. Isn't that cool? All right, enough about content. I need to sell books. I have a daughter to send to university to Ireland, no less. So please go to psscripting.com. You will find Adobe UXP plugins development with React JS and professional Photoshop UXP, or both in a convenient bundle. And you can use the promo code developerslive24 to get 30% off. It's developerslive24. And you can hit me on Threads, not X, via email, blog, or not. I wouldn't mind. It's fine. Let's keep ourselves as friendly strangers. Okay, thanks for your time. It's been a pleasure to be here. I'm done.